And joining me now to assess all of this and the whirlwind that has been the first 7 days of the Trump presidency, the five co-hosts, Kimberly Guilfoyle, Republican campaign strategist, Tony Sagg. Great to have you both here. Let's start with, you know, the big news first. A secret tape obtained from the Republican retreat in which they're concerned about the timing of the repeal of Obamacare. And this is being pushed as a big deal.
I know, but let's first repeal the term Republican retreat, right? Amen. It's really, it's like conduct unbecoming.
Especially when they have a president who is charging straight ahead.
Full steam. He had the red tie on, and he's like all go. He's like a bullfighter. It's like he's a team of one.
Did you like the picture of Ryan and McConnell by his side, on either side? I mean, it is... It's like, what in the world happened to those two people? Can't they understand that this man means to lead, and they really need to kind of get their posture right, get moving?
I mean, get it going.
Well, posture notwithstanding, I actually do think, Lou, that the Republican leadership understands they have a very strong president to follow, and they're going to cooperate
and work
with
them. They figured that out?
I think they did, frankly.
Excellent.
But you know what's interesting about this whole conversation? Obamacare repealed itself. The thing's a disaster. It's failing. It's costing too much money.
So true.
And you have essentially 12 states in which you only have one or two options. So it's not as if Republicans forced the repeal of Obamacare. So having a conversation about what are we going to replace it with is a very commonplace discussion to have. So the idea that this tape even reveals anything that suspicious or nefarious is ridiculous.
It's so obvious. And by the way, show some courage. My goodness, this man saved all of their lives and their jobs and their career and the party. Show some gratitude and show some...
Stop.
Say cojones? But you know what I mean?
Like, you can definitely say cojones. You can say cojones.
I can say that, yes.
Absolutely.
Yes, you
know, the fact of the matter is that your question, I think, is perfect. I'm not certain that I'm quite in line with you on this, Tony, but whether they know it or not, they have a leader, and all they have to do is follow. Mitch McConnell looks like he's trying to make it complicated. Ryan looks like he may be moving toward the light. You know, it's just, this could be a metamorphosis into what we don't know, but much better than what he was. What do you think?
No, you know, Lou, I'm an optimist. I have been.
Well, congratulations.
Yeah, exactly.
I have been for quite
you don't
a while.
Run it, you know, there was a time you didn't run into many Republican optimists.
He's a sunny side.
Well, here I go.
Here
I go. And, you know, having spent some time in Donald Trump's Washington, and by the way, I count
that. Listen to him brag.
I count.
Having spent some time in Donald Trump's.
And I count that time, by the way, starting after Election Day. Because have you ever seen a president-elect and now president with such an aggressive move to make key decisions and take action so quickly? And it is, by its sheer force of nature, changing the attitude there. I really do believe that.
He's a tsunami through Washington, D.C. right now. And so people need to get on board. Like we told him a long time ago on the Trump train, because that is like taking Washington by storm. He's going to get it done. I love the extreme vetting. I've been dreaming about it for so long. I wish I was in charge of it. But you know, he picks good people. I hung out with Mattis and Kelly, and they're fantastic. So we're going to get it done.
And California is talking about seceding. The Democrats are saying they're going to lay waste to the land. They're going to burn all of our supplies, our food, our weapons, as they exit Washington, apparently. They have lost their mind.
Yeah, they're so out of touch. And I think Kimberly's exactly right. When you see Donald Trump talking about the fact that he wants to prioritize protecting America, and he uses the idea of extreme vetting from countries that we know import, sadly, people who could potentially bring terror to our lands, that's a very common sense, commonplace thing. Rebuilding our military.
You mean radical Islamist terrorists?
Yeah. Absolutely. And
isn't
by the way,
great? We're free to say
that. Yeah, they got their library.
I mean, exactly. All along. Anyway,
and Merry Christmas, by the way. But the reality is, you have precedent, because Donald Trump is following the same thing Barack Obama did with Iraq.
He doesn't
Iraqi
need
refugees.
Precedent.
Yeah,
no,
it's been done.
It's been done
historically too. He's right.
Yeah.
There is that. But he would do it regardless, because it's the right thing to do, because he shows courage. This is a man of valor who took a job that is not an easy job, because he really believed he had to run and that he had to win, because things were really going awry. And he's actually following up on all his campaign promises, just like he said he would. How refreshing.
Refreshing.
Lou?
Thank you, Kimberly. Tony, thank you both.
Thank you, sir.
Appreciate it.